2, I would say. So no matter where the Lich goes, you can have the Omni Knight there to try to mitigate some of the damage, just healing up the damage from Frost Blast and kind of evening it out.
Notorious for his lane control, getting that extra XP going the way of your team. Does this feel like a good Lich game to you, Parker? Uh-oh. Wow. Double damage on Ketchik Imba. Finds a first blood in the mid lane.
Haya gets initiated on Avalanche Toss combo. He's already used the Frost Blast, and he'll have another toss in 2 seconds. So Haya probably just wants to go for a suicide. Nope, he went in for the kill and didn't find it. Meanwhile, mid lane, Lina with a Laguna Blade. Gets it up.
Still lingering around. Avalanche on 2. Heal from the Omni Knight. Out comes your Laguna onto Arteezy. Puffy's there with a slow, but he's only level 5. No Chain Frost available. Dragon Slave brings Arteezy low, but the overcharge from Wisp is enough. Zai sidesteps the LSA. Now connects with a stun onto Johnny, but he's all by his lonesome. Ohio goes over and just dunks Puffy. And now Zai, he's on the retreat. Avalanche onto Ohio. Zeus ulti flies through. A lot of low health heroes on Malaysia, but they just can't find these kills. Double kill for Ohio. Zai walks into him.
That mana drain, he's got no mana for a Burrow Strike now. Oh. KYXY comes in, cleans him up, and he's got an Omni Slash. Should Secret continue this fight, but Malaysia.
Yeah, at least not for a while. Arteezy pulling up that gold. May opt to actually skip on the drums and just go straight into the Aghanim Scepter, keeping his options open for now.
Yeah, every now and then you do see that tiny Blink Dagger. Eternal Envy especially likes to go for it, but...
Here we go. Initiation onto S4. Ohio catches him with a Berserker's Call. Laguna Blade is there. It's an easy kill. Ultimate from the zoo, or from the Lich comes out, but no bounces. Ohio will still get locked down. Compliments of the relocate. Now Johnny stunned up by Zai, in very deep and pale, only on 1. Mushi's there to heal him up. Finger almost finishes off Puppy. Now Omni Slash bounces around. Puppy will go down to the Lina and Secret. They had the fight, but now they're just getting cleaned up. Arteezy will get chased down by the Juggernaut. Now Zai, out of mana, has a couple of stick charges, but Blade Fury's there. Nowhere for him to go. And this
should maybe wait things out with that cooldown before going for another fight.
The tier 1 tower mid is rather low. They may try to just slow siege it and see what damage they can do. Force a reaction out of Secret. Healing Ward comes down, only level 1, but tower, chop, chop, chop. There's the glyph. Meanwhile, in the bottom lane, Kuro, yeah, gets initiated on into the dunk range. Ohio uses that Calling Blade and finds another one. Tier 1 tower in the mid lane will go down again, killed by the Juggernaut. KYXY 3 for 3 with these tower kills. Zai with a beautiful stun on 2. Sets it up on the jug. Nicely done. Now Johnny left behind. Blink forward from Arteezy. Will finish him off with a punch to the face. But now the rest of MY on their way in. Ohio has a blink up in 1. But no, it's Zai that reinitiates. S4 takes a Laguna. He won't survive. Again, it's a 2 for 2 around the map. Not ideal for Team Malaysia, but...
No. Comfortable position because they can split push using the Wisp Tiny.
Yeah,
Malaysia going to have to stick together a lot more because of the relocate, not to mention the blink initiation of a Sand King. But at the same time, I mean,
nope.
Bottom lane.
KYXY taking a lot of damage here. We'll try to Blade Fury away. A stun stops 2. He'll live. Ultimate from Omni Knight to turn things around. Io and Tiny in the grave. Team Malaysia ready and waiting for that one. Zai may try to reinitiate here, but Repel is still on KYXY. Gets caught by the Burrow Strike, and he ends up going down on the backside. Zeus will fall those. The rest of Team Malaysia follow up. It looks like Zai will make it out. A 1 for 3 at the end of the day. Sure,
it was a big problem. I think Secret had scouted out the lack of TPs and knew that, okay, Axe alone is not going to TP and punish us at bottom lane.
Uh-oh, Zai channeling the ulti here. Who's he going to find? Not Ohio, but jumps onto Johnny. Doesn't quite have the damage. Ohio will BKB, catches him with Berserker's Call, but relocate is on the way. Tiny and Wisp join in the party. They bring down the Lion. And now Ohio, caught without a BKB, will get comboed. The Branch doing huge damage. He will Berserker's Call for the extra bit of armor. It may be enough to live. Now KYXY TP's in. The relocate out. Zai gets left behind. Slam dunked by Ohio as he reinitiates. Puppy, now he's by himself. Chain Frost bouncing around the creeps. Ohio, hoping for some RNG. And he'll find it. Heal from Omni Knight also keeping him topped off. But things turn bad.
Coming and looks like... The plan is to look to finish off this mid-melee Rax.
S4 trying to spam out the wave as much as he can, but it's just not enough. Does this break the backdoor protection? It certainly does. KYXY, a lot of damage onto the barracks. Yule's onto Tiny. There's just no way to stop him through the repel. The power of the Omni Knight. As the mid lane of barracks is claimed from slow siege, now the toss back with Blade Fury on. Zai tries to stun him, but he can't. Now Ohio, Berserker's Call on 2 with a BKB on. Laguna brings down the Tiny. GA comes out for good measure and a Culling Blade on the Lich.
And that's a Tiny without buyback. He just purchased a Manta style using all his money, and Are they even swinging bottom lane? Looks like they may just go for the backdoor play. They haven't got creeps anywhere near bottom or top, but they say two's dead. Tiny's not buying back. Let's try and force it out. And
creeps are in the base. Well, KYXY's got plenty of sustainability to try and tank this. Zai uses the epicenter, and it does next to nothing. Secret are out of ultimates now.
This is a big, big problem with Tiny not buying back. I think Malaysia caught on to the fact he doesn't have a buyback, and they're just going to focus down the racks.
Nope, they don't. Spore gets caught. Uh-oh, relocate back to the well. He lives for now, but the Tier 3 tower has already gone down. Team Malaysia could be ready to upset Team Secret in this opening best of three.
And that's a second melee barracks. This is going to be a double lane of racks. This is suddenly becoming kind of insurmountable for Team Secret at this point, even a Wisp Tiny. This early on, I don't know if they can do it.
They're going like all in for these push items, like lying with the drums. It's not an item you see very often.
Something to give him an edge here and now. Uh-oh, Roche gets scouted out by KYXY. Uses the Blade Fury to go into the pit. Ultimate from Zeus comes out, but again, just does next to nothing. Now RTZ stunned up by the LSA.
They're all on the cliff.
Force staff onto the cliff.
Oh,
this could be
no.
A disaster. The toss down, but a finger. The Omni Slash just too much damage for Secret to handle. Now Tiny stuck in the grave, still without a buyback. At the very least, Team Malaysia will secure Roche. That's it. Puppy calls the GG. And Team Secret fall 1-2 against Team Malaysia.
That is brutal. This may be a double elimination style out of bracket, but being in the lower bracket in round one, not to mention the team you versus is either IG or Alliance, so it's going to be a tough lower bracket opponent.
Yeah.
Malaysia have got to be so happy for themselves right now. They've just beaten one of the best teams in Europe. And
wow.
Considering their position where they're looking to prove themselves for a TI5 invite, this means a lot right now.
It really does.